My name is Mendel Blechschmidt. I'm the author of multiple COVID-19 simulations in Germany. And in this video, I'm going to show you how you can do your own simulation. So first you can see my GitHub repository. And the first thing what you should do is you should fork the repository. And after you fork the repository, you should clone your repository to your local computers. To do that, you click on clone or download. You copy the URL. Then you go into a normal CLI, or you can also use another Git client. In my case, I have a Git folder, and then you type in Git and clone, and then you paste the URL, and then you press enter. In my case, I already have this folder, so I don't have to clone it. So what I will do is now I will go into the folder. And now I will show you some data sources that you can use. So I'm mainly using QGIS, and in QGIS there are multiple services that you can use for free data. So in my example, the most important source for me is the Orca I data from the Robert Koch Institute based on the CRISE data. And this is the source of the ArcGIS experience for the COVID-19 ArcGIS GIS experience for this dashboard. So if you're looking on this dashboard here, and then you go to Landkreise, here you can directly import this data into your QGIS. So what you have to do is you have to first get the URL. So this is this URL. I will put this in the description. Then you click on new connection. You paste the URL here. You type in RKI Landkreisdaten, for example, and then you click OK. And then afterwards you will have this layer, and you can add this layer here. So in my particular case, I created some fillings to see in which of the districts there are lots of COVID-19 cases, and you can see that especially around Heinsberg, around here, there are lots of cases. Give me just a moment, so I will edit the layer style. So where's the layer style labeling here? And now we can go into styling, so which is here. And now we, for example, what you can do is, currently we can't really see where there are lots of cases, so we will just set the cast to 50, or let's take 200. And now it should be more possible to see where there is where there are lots of cases and where there are not lots of cases. So you can see here this, there are lots of cases, and currently in every color appears the same as in the same amount. But what we can also try, we can use equal intervals. So this is now a little bit more useful, because now if we set it to 50, we can really see that Heinsberg, for example, and also there's Niederlohnekreis, which should be somewhere in Bavaria, where there are also lots of cases. Okay, so if we have this data, we can look into the attribute table. So this is the attribute table. This is the data that we have. For example, there's Heinsberg. And here in the end, there is data from the COVID cases, like the death rate, the cases, cases per 100,000 population. And I also have some data from the Statistische Landesamt Rheinland-Pfalz and Statistische Landesamt Nordrhein-Westfalen, where they gave me access to the ICU units based on Landkreis. But currently, I only have this data for Rheinland-Pfalz and Nordrhein-Westfalen, so this can be seen here. And we will run our simulation only on this data. So what we will do is we will just mark all these all the districts where we have data for. And now what we will, so these are now selected, and what we can do now is we can run some geo plugins to create a new layer with centroids, and then export the centroid layer for further processing. So like you have to do geometry tools, then centroids, then Landkreise, then selected features only, and then just run. Close. So now if I close the hospitals and the Landkreise, I can see here, these are the centroids. And if I go here into the open attributes table, I will see that I still have the same data, but I only have one point, which represents the district. So what I have to do now is I have to export this data. So export, save features as. And now let's go into Germany and let's create a new folder. Let's just call it rp env create. And then this is ICU units rpnp germany.geojson save. Okay. Oh, I forgot something. I have to use as the coordinate system. I have to use WGS84. So this is the default for GeoJSON. And if you don't use that, you won't be able to process this data in another software. Okay, so let's just delete the file. Just give me 1 second. Okay, so let's go into this folder, Germany, CD Germany. Then and then delete this file again and recreate the file. So ICU units on ICU units COVID-19 on districts dot JSON. Save. No, like this. Okay. Okay. So now we exported this. Now let's go into coding. So I'm using. Yeah, this was okay. There was just a message that the RKA dashboard didn't work anymore, but we are not using it anymore. So now we go into the COVID-19 scenarios repository. This was created by. Robert Nela, Professor Dr. Robert Nela from the University of Basel, in collaboration with Jan Albert from Stockholm, who's a professor as well. And I'm just using this model. So they created this model. It's an awesome model. It's written in TypeScript. I already sent them some pull requests. They are very responsive. They are working on it. Okay, so what you can see here now is this run.test.tsx, that's the real file where I run my simulations on. Technically, it's a yarn test file, so it's not really an run file, it's just a test case, but this test case in the end creates my GeoJSON file that I put into Kepler-GL. So now I will just put here in video. And you don't really have to understand all this code to use it. Try to understand it, because this is very important in the end to interpret the results. So now we have to load the data that we just created. So let's import the import it. So let's just modify this data here. So rpnw, and then normally there should be Germany rpnw. So this is the file. Let's rename this into JSON. Okay, so now we loaded the data that we just created in QGIS into this variable. And this variable will be used in the simulation. So now, to make this a little bit faster, we will only run this for 1 month. And now what we have to do is we just have to execute the command yarn test. So this now runs our simulation. And this will create in the end So this ran the simulation. Maybe the audio was a little bit bad because there are lots of CPU cycles used for the simulation. This now created a file in the simulation folder. And if you type in git status, you will see that there is a new file. So that's the new file. I will need this. And now this is the GeoJSON that we can put into Kepler-GL. So we go to kepler.gl/demo. And now we can use drag and drop to put this file there. So that's the new file. So let's paste it into Kepler-GL. And now we have to configure Kepler-GL in a way that we really see what's happening there. So the first thing what we will doing is we will add a time filter. So this will give us this nice board here. This nice timeline where we can scroll over it. So if you're interested, for example, for the peak, you can set the x-axis to intensive total, and this go gives you a histogram of the amount of people that will be in intensive total. And you can see here that for 1 month simulation, we are by far not at the end yet. So there's still lots of people needing intensive care, and we are not done yet. So the number rises a lot. So let's go back to normal y-axis. So let's ch because this makes the processing very slow if you show a normal histogram based on time here. And now let's make the visualization a little bit better. As a fill color, we will use the field intensive total. No, sorry. We will use the field ICU overcapacity, hospital overcapacity, and we will show it with two colors. So custom palette. Let's delete this one. Confirm. So and this now makes the points change the color if they are overcapacity. So if I hover here, you can see that overcapacity is reached in around 2 weeks. And now what I can also do is I can make the radius based on intensive total. Let's make it 300. So this is the radius which will scale. And now if we run it, we can see our simulation, and we can see that some bubbles will turn red. And if you hover over the bubbles, you can see the labels. And for the labels, you can show more fields. So if you go here to brush, so for example, if we want to see the intensive total and the infectious total as well, we can click here. And now if I hover over the bubbles, I can see that. So for example, here for Heinsberg, you can see that there are 250,000 of people are living there, and that on the 4th April, there are 15 people needing intensive care. And I already read on Twitter that they already had last week. They were an overcapacity in some of the hospitals there, and they distributed the people to some hospitals around this place. I hope this helps you to make a similar simulation, and feel free to contact me on Twitter. And I hope that we will continue to have a happy life after this huge crisis. Bye bye.